He is your friend and mine. He is George Rush St. Pierre. There he is. Hello, George. How are you?
How are you, Ariel? I'm doing well. And you?
I'm doing very well. It's nice to see you. What a beautiful shirt you have on for us today. Did you get dressed up for us?
As just for you, man. Just for the audience.
Wow. What a gent. By the way, why is your phone like that? Are you not able to turn it? Why is it vertical? Are you able? It doesn't work.
Yeah, I got... There was something that happened on the road, and I didn't have enough time to get to the location that I wanted to be, so I had to park on the side and do it. I mean, it's a mess.
Oh,
so that's why I had to put it this way. I'm sorry, guys.
No problem, no problem. Are you okay to do it now, or are you stressed out? I don't want to stress you out.
Oh, no, I'm perfect. I'm perfect.
Okay, all right. Well, thank you so much for the time, George. It's always a pleasure. I would take you if you texted us on the program. So this is a nice treat to see your face. It's great to have you on. Coming to us from Montreal. I see Montreal behind you, right? Is this Montreal behind you?
Yeah, I'm in Montreal. I'm home. Yeah, I came back Saturday night.
Okay, so you didn't stick around for the event?
No, I had to go because I had different businesses to take care of. I had to go to when I left Austin to go to Vegas. Then Vegas, I went to Toronto on Friday, and then I came back on Saturday. I missed the main event. Apparently, it was an amazing fight, and I missed it. I just saw the result when I came back home.
Wow!
Unfortunately,
you know, it's funny. I just wanted to ask you. I know you didn't see the fight itself, but to me, because I'm sure you've seen him before, Alex Volkanovski is the first fighter to remind me of you in the UFC, how professional he is, how smart he is. The way he fights remind me a lot of you. Do you see that similarity as well?
Well, the way I see Alex Volkanovski is he's not a specialist. He's very good everywhere. And me, when I was fighting, that was my strength. I was not the best at something, but I was good everywhere. So I was able to become the perfect nemesis to my opponent. And I think he's using a similar... a similar strategy. When you fight someone, he takes always his opponent outside of his comfort zone.
So you enjoy watching him?
Oh, yeah. He's one of my favorite fighters to watch. I love watching him. I think he's the best right now. The best, probably the best active fighter, the best pound for pound right now.
I agree with that. Okay, so let's talk about your news.
And also, yeah? Also the fact that he beat Rodriguez. Like for his legacy is just amazing because he's one of the fighters that was able to beat the older generation. He beat his own generation, and now he's starting to beat the future generation. And this is amazing for him.
Sort of like you.
Well, I did something similar too, and we're not the only one, you know. And I think when you talk about the best in the world and of all time, and when you start getting into that category, this is one of the criteria that they need to have. All the fighters that are entering these sort of GOAT name, they call, because I think it's very subjective. That's one of the criteria that they need to have.
I agree with that very much. On Thursday, we found out you're coming back. You're competing, not in MMA, but in grappling. First, can I ask you, I have a few questions about this, obviously. Can I ask, how long has this been in the works for? When did the discussion surrounding this start?
Well, a few months. The thing is, I love jiu-jitsu. I love grappling. I mean, it's also a sport, I believe, that it's accessible to more people, a bigger range of people, because MMA, it's not everybody that want to compete in MMA because they don't want to get brain damaged. But grappling is a sport that is accessible to a much bigger audience. And when the UFC told me that they want to get into this, I wanted to be part of their promotion, try to help the sport growing. And I think they start small a little bit, but eventually it will become, and the shows will be hosted in big arenas. That's my goal. I want to help the organization to get to that point, you know?
Okay, so that they've done four of those. You're going to be on the broadcast for the fifth, and then in December you're going to compete, right?
Yeah, exactly. And this December 14th.
December 14th, you're going to compete. Can you tell us what the rules will be? Like, what are we looking at as far as your match?
We don't know the rules because I don't compete. I'm not back to trying to be world champion here. It's a different mindset than when I was competing in mixed martial art. I'm competing for the kick of it. Of course, I'm a very, very competitive person, and I will do my best. But I think it will be best for me, for the audience, for I think it will be best for everybody if I match against an opponent, another maybe a veteran of MMA or you know someone that comes from the MMA world and not someone who comes from well. I think that will be better for me for the promotion, for the fans, because there's guys that will compete that are guys that want to be world champion, like Gordon Ryan, Giancarlo. These guys really compete to become the best grappler. That's their specialty. That grappling never been my specialty. What made my strength that we talk about before is the fact that I'm able to do everything very well. I'm a very complete person, but now complete fighter. But now I'm going into something that is very specialized into grappling. And I'm 42 years old. So I think the thing with it is to have fun, do what give the fans what they want to see, and you know to train well, train you know as serious as if I would be going for a mixed martial art fight.
So as of right now, you don't have an opponent, right?
I'm sorry.
As of right now, you don't have an opponent, right?
I do not have an opponent right now. No, I don't.
Is there someone that's close to being like? Are they in talks with anyone? Are you close to someone?
I'm going to have to discuss. There are many, many options. And it's hard to know right now because there's a lot of fighters when they retire. A lot of them, they gain a lot of weight. Some lose a lot of weight. Some are just, they have an unhealthy lifestyle and they cannot no longer go back to competition. So I need to check who's available, and you know, it could be also an active fighter, but some have different agenda. Some are maybe about to get a world title fight. So I need to check with the UFC, and we didn't have the time to talk right now.
Okay. And is there a weight for this, like this match, or is it open weight?
Well, the rules can be subject to changes, the weight as well. I personally would like to compete at 170. Because I walk around 180 pounds now. So, and the rules, I believe it's best for the audience, for the promotion, and for the fighters, especially for the show. If we try to make the sport bigger, it needs to be attractive for the audience. We need to make a set of rules that promotes finishes and not only stalling. That a set of rules that will promote the finishes and we're in discussion with on that right now.
Could I ask if the promotion of the UFC came to you and said, George, who is your number one choice? We're going to go and try to make this happen. What would be your response?
Oh, it will be there's a few names. There's a few names that could be good. I want. There's a few names. It's just I think I need to have someone who's a formidable opponent that is you know what I mean, like someone that the fans want to see me compete against.
Oh, we lost you. Okay, it was a great cliffhanger. You were about to tell us a name and then you disappeared and I was like, oh my gosh, George, what's happening?
Oh, sorry. No. I think there's many guys. That could be an option. That there are guys that are veteran fighters that have a good grappling background. I'm talking about maybe the Diaz brothers could be a guy. I don't know. Like I'm a competitive guy, and I something like that. Maybe I think the fans will want to see. Or it could be someone that is active. You know, right now that is currently active. I don't know, Usman, Covington, something, someone like this. You know, it depends. I want to give I think it's up to the audience to choose who they would like to see. And I think it needs to be a formidable opponent too, like someone that is from a grappling background. I'm not really an interest on fighting someone who's more like only a striking background, because I don't think that the fans will be pleased with that. I think it needs to be, you know, someone that will give the fans a good show. You know, we're there more. I'm doing this more as a novelty competition match than a competition match that is there for a ranking to sure. have a place among to be the best. Because I have no illusion. I'm 42 years old. You know what I mean? And I have other priority that are more important than this right now. Even though I'm gonna show up and be in the best shape of my life for this, that I can be in the best, the most well prepared that I can be.
Can I tell you my top two choices? You didn't ask me, but...
I would love to hear. Okay. I would love it.
Number one, I think you've heard this one, Khabib, just because it's the fight that yes. was talked about. I think it would be an incredible scene. Any chance of Khabib?
I'm not sure. I think he's retired. I think he's retired. And
but so are you. This is different.
His name was not on the list. It was not in the talk, but... You know, I think he's retired, and I'm not sure if he's still in the circus okay. circuit of doing martial art right now.
Nick Diaz rematch, grappling only.
That could be an interesting one. And he's very good. He's a very good grappler. He's got grappling. He's got more experience than me in grappling. So yeah. I would have to make sure I come very well prepared for this one if it's Nick Diaz.
When would you like to know the opponent? When is it important to know? Like, does it matter if you don't know for a while, or do you want it to be done sooner rather than later? Does it even, you know, bother you?
No, I think because it's we still have a lot of time. It's yeah. in December 14. But I would like to know, like at the latest, maybe in late October, I would like to have a name, you know, like some guys. I understand that they have other things on their agendas that are more pressing, and I understand. But I would like to know a little bit ahead of time. It doesn't change the fact that I'm gonna start. I'm training. I'm always in shape, but it's good to know a little bit ahead of time so you can start. You know, make your training more specialized
sure.
Towards and gear it towards the opponent that you will face.
And you mentioned this is a novelty. Any chance there's going to be more than one, or do you think it's one and done for you?
I want to do more than one. That's why I want to test the water. I never did this before. It's I competed in Abu Dhabi a long time ago, a few years ago, and I didn't have the experience that I have now. It's a different thing, a different set of rules. I never did this. I'm going to be outside of my comfort zone, you know, and that's the fun thing. I like also the fact that, you know, because I'm retired from mixed martial art, there's always a danger if you don't tap, you know, your arm can snap. It's hard on the body, but because there's no limited damage to the head because there's no strike, it's safer, and that's what I like. I think it's an avenue that a lot of athletes, a lot of fighters, when they retire from mixed martial art, they can have. And if they still have the kick of competition and they still want to make money with it, so that's why I'm promoting it too. And it's also not only for a retired fighter; it's also a serious competition, because people will have a chance to witness some of the best grappler in the world. You know, some are like Gordon Ryan. In my book, he's the best. The best grappler of all time in grappling. But it's a very specialized combat sport, and it's made for that purpose, and I'm excited about it.
You have told me and others in the past that before your fights, you would get very anxious, very nervous, right? And you loved the training, but you hated the fight night, right? That's the part you really don't miss. Do you think you'll have those same feelings leading up to this and on the event itself, or because it's not for the UFC belt and all that, like the pressure is completely different?
No, I think I will have the nerves. I will be stressed. And I like it because that's when I perform at my best, and I need it. I might not be as bad as when I was fighting in mixed martial arts, because when I was fighting, being champion, being the best was my number one priority. Now it's still very important. I have other things more important, but I'm feeling it right now. You know what I mean? The tension, and it's going to build up and get worse and worse. I don't like that feeling, but I like to win, Ariel.
Yes.
So I think it's worth it.
I love it. By the way, gi or no gi?
No gi.
No gi. You don't do gi?
Yeah. No, I think it's more no-gi because I'm. It will be more against fighters, okay. Mixed martial art fighters. I think it's no-gi. It's something that it's more appropriate.
Okay, and I'll just ask you a couple more things, and then I'll let you go because I feel bad that you're sitting in your car here doing this. Could I ask you, George? Yesterday we found out that a man you know very well, Francis Ngannou, is fighting Tyson Fury in a boxing match. What was your reaction to this news?
Yeah, I don't know if it, I didn't know it was official. You just mentioned. Yeah, it's official now. Wow. Well, I'm glad for Francis because he's going to make a lot of money. A lot of money. Probably a lot more than all his fight in UFC. But on the other hand, like, my heart is with Francis, but he's going to take on the champion, the best boxer in his sport. So he is the one who's going into another sport. So the odds will not favor him. But, you know, we never know. You know, we never know. You know, a big punch coming from out of nowhere could seal the deal. But I even though the odds are not in his favor, my heart is with him.
Do you think he's making a mistake by going in there and potentially, you know, he's the big underdog, right? It's not like he's fighting some lower level guy. Do you think that's a mistake?
Well, if he goes out there, I mean, everybody wants to win, you know, like, and I really hope for him that he wins this fight. But I believe if he goes out there and he performs well and he showcases some good skill and he looks good against the champion, and even if he loses, but he looks good, he doesn't take too much brain damage to, you know, I think he could be good. He's going to make a lot of money. It could be good for him. The question is it how it's going to happen? I don't know. Tyson Fury is very good. And boxing is a very limited and specialized combat sport, you know? If you would do the same fight in mixed martial art, I would give Francis one round.
Right.
Maybe not even a round. Three minutes and it will be over. Like, even probably less than 3 minutes. But in boxing, I know for a fact, I'm pretty sure that Francis can last much longer in boxing against Tyson Fury than Tyson Fury will last against Francis in mixed martial art.
Mm. I remember 2 years ago, there was some talk of you versus Oscar, but you had the UFC deal. Now that you're free from that, any consideration to doing a boxing match?
Well, it's not in the horizon. I the last time it was against Oscar, a big part of it would have been given to charity. It was well organized. It was with bigger gloves, you know, like, I would have done it because, you know, it's a serious competition with high risk. But we try to bring the risk to a minimum and for a good cause, for a charity. There's nothing to the horizon right now. Right now, what is under the horizon is the submission wrestling, jiu-jitsu, grappling match with the UFC.
Okay. And last one for you. Just last month, you know, I'm a proud Canadian like you are, proud Montrealer, and I can't help but support Canadian MMA and want to see Canadian MMA do well. And it was a beautiful scene last month in Vancouver when the six Canadian fighters all won on the card. And it gave me hope that, you know, with those fighters and Olivier Aubin-Mercier doing his thing in PFL and other fighters in other organizations, that maybe Canadian MMA is back, because let's be honest, it wasn't too good over the last few months. Can I ask your opinion on that night? Did you watch it that night in Vancouver? Did you feel a sense of pride? And how do you feel about the current state of Canadian MMA?
I was there, Ariel.
That's
I was
right,
there.
You were there. Beautiful.
I lived it, you know, I breathed the same air. I was there. It was great. I was so happy for all the Canadian athletes. And I think it goes by waves. When I was competing, I was very fortunate. I had the help of Dennis Kang, David Loiseau, Rory McDonald, Steve Vigneault, Jonathan Goulet. I had Patrick Côté. I had so many other athletes, amazing athletes that were competing in the same time that I was. So it gives me a big push. That's the way I see it. I was very fortunate. Without the help of all these guys, my training partner, being champion would probably not have been possible for me. So I had very high level training partners, you know. A lot of these guys, they fought for a world title, you know, like Patrick Côté, David Loiseau, they fought for a world title. Rory McDonald fought for a world title. Dennis Kang fought over in in Japan. So I had the incredible training partner. When I was training in the room, it was filled of very, very high level athletes. So that's why in that era we're doing so well. And I think it's coming back. I think it goes by era like this, you know, okay. It's waves. Now we see guys from New Zealand doing very well. It was never the case before, you know, like now they're coming out because they all train together, they stick together, and they rise together. That's how it is. Training need to be competitive, but it should not be malicious. When you train with a guy and it's malicious, you want to hurt him. Now that's not good training. It needs to be very competitive. You know, you want to win. It's serious competition, but it's not malicious. You're there to help each other. And that's what makes a good team. And I was lucky in my time, in my era, when I was competing in my prime, that's what I had. I had great training partners, highly competitive, but not malicious. They were true. We were true to each other, and we were there for one another. And that's what it needs done in Canada. You know, they need to train together, and because if they stay in their alone in their areas and not mixing it up, they cannot be competitive against the world. We're too much of our country is big in terms of territory, but in terms of population, we're not big enough to go up against U.S. and Europe, Russia. We need to stick together and train together. So every Friday when I was young, I remember every Friday was the day that we all show up in the same gym, spar with each other for a few hours. Then after we go back to our own routine. And we used to see each other once a week. And I'm the one who made that at the time. And it was great. It allowed us to exchange ideas, exchange technique, and to improve much faster than our competitors.
I love that. And by the way, thinking of you training, I have to ask you this. I can't believe I just said last question. I'm sorry. But you and Elon Musk, this happened. Did it really just happen from the tweet? Like, you sent him the tweet. Then what? How do you get invited to go train with him? How does that happen from the tweet? Is that how it all went down?
Yeah, that's how it all went down. And I have a friend. His name is Lex Fridman.
Yes.
He's friend with Elon Musk as well. And he told me that, because he knew I was going to Austin, Texas, and I'm going there quite often. And I think Elon has a residence there. So, you know, the timing was just good. He called me, say, if you want to train with Elon, let's do it. And I went there and I trained with him. And it was a great experience. I really admire Elon. He's someone I really look up to for everything that he has done, his accomplishment, and the ideas that he stands for. He's a very nice, nice guy, very jovial, great sense of humor. He's actually very strong, much stronger than the average man. Very tough, and he's got a background in judo.
Are you going to do more training with him?
Nothing is planned right now, but I'm going to have to go back more often to Austin, Texas to get ready for that grappling. And maybe, I'm not sure. I told him that if he needs my help, I'm there to help him out.
Do you think the fight happens? Him versus Zuck, do you think it happens?
I don't know. And to tell you the truth, Ariel, and I know it's like dropping a cold shower on everybody now, if I say this. A guy like Elon Musk is so busy. Most of his time is dedicated to work on things that changes the fate of humanity.
Yeah.
It's the world. So I think it's better that if he stay focused on this instead of trying to get ready for a cage fight. That's my belief.
Fair. But yesterday, did you see Zuck with Israel and Volkanovski?
Yeah, I saw that. And I think that there is great value on them training in martial art. I think there's great value into that. But I just hope that fight does not happen for both of them. You know, it could be given to a charity, but I think they're above that. You know, it's too important. What they're working on is too important.
Fair enough. Well said. I respect you for saying that. George, thank you very much. Congratulations on your new vodka, Pure Sang, I think it is.
Yeah. That's mean, if you translate, mean thoroughbred.
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 Okay. I thought Sang was
thoroughbred. Yeah.
I thought Sang was like for blood. Isn't blood, is
It is, but you cannot translate word by word because French is from Latin base. If you translate pourcent, it means a thoroughbred. You know, someone special, like a thoroughbred, a horse is a thoroughbred.
Okay.
A fighter, thoroughbred, or a thoroughbred is a special athlete, you know?
Okay.
A pourcent.
Like
that's
you.
Why our body, yeah.
I love it. And what a great honor it was to watch the wrestling with you. Back in February, you and I in the front row over there watching Brock Lesnar. That was great fun at the Bell Center. So always a pleasure, my friend. Thank you so much for the time and good luck. And good luck getting that opponent. And I can't wait to see you back in action in December.
Thank you, Ariel. Hopefully I'll get to see you soon and maybe in a wrestling show. I love to go. It's amazing. And what a show it was.
It was amazing.
Thank you again.
I would love it. Thank you, George. All the best to you. There he is. The one and only, the greatest of all time. George Rush St. Pierre, I mean, what a guy. How do you not feel better about life?